you see them, they'll be like, hey, I used to work at PE.
Back there, GE Air, back there, GE Aerospace.
Oh, cool. There's a mark here. What is this?
I didn't plan
Okay. I have a copy for you that you can buy.
Yeah.
Stuff for your flight.
They got white castles. Yep. They got all the everything.
Self-checkout. I have like 5 minutes. Okay. I'm going to make sure that's in front of you.
Is this the terminal?
I don't know.
The, commercial flight?
So this is the there's half of the building that's
I'm not okay. I can't get rid of them. I didn't realize they had so much classroom space over here.
I think this is a new building, right?
For yeah, it's relatively new.
Well, where's the commercial side? Is this a commercial building? That's a new commercial building?
No, it's not open.
Yeah.
Today for the event.
Oh, okay.
But of course there is. If you go out, if you go on our exit and you look like straight across, it's like Enterprise, and then you'll see a building just beyond it, that's going to be the new commercial building.
Cool. Thank you. Got a control room for testing.
He was grabbing the door frame, and he was pulling on it, not letting me go, and the door was open on his hands. I can now imagine. Yeah.
And we were wondering, okay, so this is my picture building.
Yeah,
being the one.
Thank you. For those of you who are just joining us, we'd like to extend a welcome to Purdue Aviation Day 2024, presented by Envoy Air. We have a fun-filled day in store for you. In order for you and your family to make the most out of today's event, we invite you to download our Purdue Aviation Day event guide onto your mobile device, which can be accessed by visiting www.purdueaviationday.com/guide. Once again, that's www.purdueaviationday.com/guide.
The smaller the space, the less weight it has to carry. Keeps the weight down on the plane, I guess.
Got
big smaller weight.
Yeah.
If you're time with us at Purdue Aviation Day 2024, presented by Envoy Air, this coming to an end, we'd appreciate more of your time in order to complete our guest experience exit survey. This survey is instrumental to our planning processes and will ensure that Purdue Aviation Day 2025 will be the best one yet. The survey can be accessed by scanning the QR codes on the A-frames located at the event exit or on the back of your event guide. Right before our formal welcoming ceremonies that will commence at 11:30 a.m., we'll be hosting yet another session of What's It Like to Be an Aviator at 11:20 a.m. Backed by popular demand, we are thrilled to be bringing the professionals back to you. Our third rendition of What's It Like to Be an Aviator is coming up here at 11:20, and we are thrilled to be joined by legendary aviatrix and military pilot, Heather Penny. We'll talk all about her legendary career in aviation and pursuing careers in military aviation. Be sure to stop by the main stage for this exciting Q&A. Before our formal welcome ceremonies commence, be sure to have a chance to grab your exclusive pad merch. If you've not gotten an opportunity to head over to the pad store, you are missing out on some sweet tees, polos, quarter zips, and other merchandise that can only be purchased today here in person. Stop by the pad store, which is located near the main event exit, in order to pick up your exclusive mementos of Purdue Aviation Day 2024, presented by Envoy Air, wonderful you at home.
Yeah. I know. And planes are not my thing.
Yeah.
Don't go under that wing. You're a little too tall for the camera. Maybe the test pilot is cool with what he says on the side.
Yeah.
They got a big hangar over here. Hangar for lease.
I think this is, they're gonna have, these are for the show.
What?
They're gonna fly some of these for the show.
This is going to be around 1 o'clock. Yeah, nice.
They don't think they want to do all of that. Let's do this first and see how that works.
That makes sense.
I think that's still a venture plan. Assuming that there's other stuff down.
I'm screaming him not to jump.
He's like, I know them.
I'm gonna go get some more. For those of you who are just joining us, good morning and welcome to Purdue Aviation Day 2024, presented by Envoy Air. We have a fun-filled day in store for you. In order for you and your family to make the most out of today's events, we invite you to download our Purdue Aviation Day event guide onto your mobile device, which can be accessed by visiting www.purdueaviationday.com/guide. Once again, that's www.purdueaviationday.com/guide. It's backed by popular demand. At 2024, presented by Envoy Air, is thrilled to be bringing the professionals back to you today. As we welcome back, what's it like to be an aviator to the main stage for the second year in a row? Our third guest is legendary aviatrix and military pilot, Heather Penny. Let's welcome her to the stage now. Thanks for joining us today, Heather.
Nick, thank you so much. It's such an honor to be here.
You've done seemingly everything when it comes to the aviation industry. Could you just name a highlight of your journey in aviation?
So my journey through aviation, some of the things that I've loved is, as you mentioned, all of the different aspects that I've been able to do through aviation, whether or not that's flying a Cub through, you know, the golden hour, to flying the F-16, to racing jets at Reno, or continuing to fly aerobatics in my own personal aircraft, or even flying a Citation. So I've just been very privileged to experience many of the different types of aviation that our world offers, and I'm so grateful to be here and support you.
Thank you so much for that. Aviation Day 2024 echoes the same back to you. And you could have known one thing about the aviation industry or flying in general before entering into it. Tell us more young over there.
So one of the things I would tell our young aviators out there is continue to pursue your passion. We all will experience challenges, but it is worth the work, it is worth the heart. And if you invest yourself, there's so much that you can receive back from the aviation community.
Awesome.
Thank you.
So you've had an extensive career in the military and the National Guard. What are some of the differences in between the military and commercial flying? Does the flying that you do differ with these different areas of the military as well?
So flying that I do commercially as a contract pilot for Citations is very different from the kinds of flying that I did when I was in the military flying F-16s. Flying F-16s is very operationally focused, as you can imagine. We take takeoff and landing for granted, if you will, because we're really focused on the tactics and the employment and the threats that we might have to face as we go into combat. But what we do as a Citation pilot or as a commercial pilot, you really have different aircraft systems that you're working with, flight management system, and really providing a comfortable and safe experience for your passengers.
It's great to know. So what is it like to be a woman in military aviation?
Being a woman in the military aviation really is not any different than what any military aviator faces. We all have the same technology that we need to do. We all have the same tactics that we need to fly. But what is different are how I had to balance my family with my military service. I will say that it's important to understand that we're all in this together. We're in the military because we love what we do, because there is a mission, because there is a purpose, and that's what we need to focus on. We're providing support, mutual support to everyone within the fighter squadron, everyone of our...
Do you see a sign for what? Is this a runway de-icer?
It's how we manage our personal lives.
Yeah, airport maintenance.
It's like they can sweep, they got a big wide brush to sweep snow or debris or something.
Heather Penny, by aviation journey. What can people expect to hear during your guest speaking session?
When I take the stage at 12:15, I will share my experiences on the morning of 9/11, but I will also then talk about the rest of my aviation journey and what brought me to that point in time and where I've been since then.
Fantastic. And I'm going to close with the same question that I've asked now in the past.
What is this, runway de-icing?
This is a snow group. One of our snow removal equipment pieces. We've got two of these. We've also got three big plows and a really, really big snow blower.
Okay.
In light snows, up in medium, two pieces of equipment out. So they really scour down a bare pavement. The broom head usually goes at about a 30-degree to the left or right.
Okay.
These right here, they're on each side, they're air blasts, and you can see all the hydraulics on them.
Uh-huh.
They're linked to the broom head, so whichever way the broom head is pushing, Both of those blasts, air blasts, will duct over and blow left or right. That's about a 200 mile an hour wind that comes out of it. They actually go a little bit lower to the ground when we're in motion.
Yeah.
They're up in travel mode right now.
Okay.
But yeah, 200 mile an hour wind right along the ground up, really scour down to the.
We're not going by special guests.
Back if you want to talk to the truck, the middle is the auxiliary, the brake, and the hydraulic pump powers both the crew, so the pump here on the glass, and the same hot tub, and the full-time all-wheel drive, it's got all-wheel steer, so you can front steer, you can rear steer, a coordinated steer to make a real tight turn.
Yeah.
And then also you can crab steer to kind of go at an angle like that.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, and it's all of the snow removal functions are handled by a joystick. It's other than that, it's just like driving a really, really big car.
So yeah.
It's the somebody asked, like, oh, is there kind of some kind of specialized training? Like the three of us out here got like hands-on training from the folks that delivered it.
Okay.
And then with that, we were comfortable enough to train the rest of our operators.
Nice.
With it. So it's, I mean, you know, obviously figuring out some of the options and getting gadgets and gizmos in there. There's a little bit more to it. But
yeah.
Get in, put it in gear, turn the broom on, you're good. That's
nice.
It.
That's pretty slick.
I was like, we've had students out here and be like, you know, it's just like your mom and dad's minivan, except it weighs 40 tons, you know?
Yeah.
So if a part goes wrong, do you have Caterpillar come out and do that?
So this is actually, they're Caterpillar engines. The machine itself is assembled by a group called MB. They're out of Appleton, Wisconsin. So we would have either MB or one of their service representatives. There's all kinds of companies and that kind of stuff. It's mostly MB. But yeah, we would have them come out and work on whatever it is. It's mostly electronics issues we have because there's so many computers that control these things.
Okay.
Sometimes they have to come out and put updates on them. But
yeah.
the regular seasonal maintenance our transportation shop has been trained to take care of.
Okay.
Because big trucks are big trucks, you know. There's not that much difference between them. It's just how you arrange them and what you put on them. So.
That's cool.
So how many millions of dollars?
This is about $550,000.
Okay.
Yeah, that's not
that's
bad.
That's cheaper than I thought it would
this
be.
This is $550,000. The fire truck over there, that we got in 2021, that was a little over $750,000.
Okay, wow.
So, yeah.
I wouldn't have even guessed that was. I was wondering what that was, and I wouldn't have guessed it was a fire truck.
Yep. Huh. Yeah, that's a specialized, and I think there should be a firefighter over there.
Yeah.
Probably speak more intelligently to it, but that's what's called a crash truck or an ARF truck, airport rescue and firefighting. Their whole thing, the reason they're so beefy is that that carries 1,500 gallons of water and enough foam concentrate to turn that all into that special firefighting foam that they use on fuel fires.
Okay.
So the whole idea is that thing, through any weather, any terrain, that thing's got to be able to move that 1,500 gallons of water anywhere on the field. So
gotcha.
They are monster trucks.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I always joke when we're clearing snow, like, we have to keep the emergency path clear.
Yeah.
But if the weather's too bad for that thing to get out, we got bigger problems.
Yeah, no kidding. You know?
But yeah, that machine's really neat. It's got the turret on top.
Uh-huh.
And it's all controlled. You can control it all from a single driver in there.
Wow.
It's got the turret on top. There's a turret on the bumper, pretty right about here. And then with the newer ones, they've actually got it so that they can, that bumper turret is on an arm that can lower, so you can do like an undershot underneath something.
Gotcha.
So
okay.
It's a really, really neat piece of equipment.
Huh. That is cool.
So. Nice. All the parts.
Yeah, this is cool.
Yeah.
Well, thanks for the explanation.
Of course.
Appreciate it.
Oh, so is this what we would be flying if we went
in? I'm not sure, actually.
Isn't it Southern Airway, or is this
Yeah, they did say it was
style?
Southern.
We operate into Hartsfield in Atlanta, and DFW. Markets from Arkansas. We are out in the west.
Now he's vanished, but he's over there. Okay. He's getting on the military plane.
You got
That wasn't too crazy of me, like, it was safe.
Oh, it's fine.
Oh, that's cool.
Didn't dig it.
I should get, like Zelda Breath of the Wild.
Yeah.
For those of you that are just joining us, you can find our airport guide to all of today's festivities by visiting our website at www.purdueaviationday.com/guide. We will now begin our formal welcoming ceremonies, which will begin with the playing of our national anthem, the Star Spangled Banner. Our ceremonies will feature appearances from Jonah Rifkin and Jeffrey Watts, the executive directors of Purdue Aviation Day, as they formally welcome you to Purdue Aviation Day 2024, presented by Envoy Air. In addition, we are honored to be joined by the Dean of the Purdue Polytechnic Institute, Dr. Daniel Castro, as well as the head of the School of Aviation and Transportation Technology, Dr. Brian Doman. We are also honored to have the FAA Associate Administrator of Airports, Shanetta Griffin, join us to give remarks on behalf of the Federal Aviation Administration. Finally, we'll hear from Austin Decker, Manager of Pilot Recruitment for Envoy Air, the presenting sponsor of Purdue Aviation Day 2024. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, if I could please have everyone face toward the food trucks and the gap in between the terminal building and the Neiswanger Hall to the flag at the front of the terminal building and remove their caps as we play our national anthem. Thank you. Our first dignitary that will be offering remarks this morning is one of the most prominent figures within the Federal Aviation Administration. As the Associate Administrator for Airports, Shanetta Griffin is responsible for overseeing the safe operation of our nation's airports. Her team of over 600 personnel manages a cash flow of over $3 billion and has ensured that America's airport facilities are world-class. We are excited to welcome Administrator Griffin and her team to Purdue to also recruit our university's deep talent for careers in the FAA and to provide unparalleled insight into Purdue's recent announcement of our commercial air service that will be returning to the Purdue University Airport on May 15th. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the main stage Administrator Shanetta Griffin.
Beautiful day, and very hard work, and I appreciate all the hard work. So thank you all for having me today, Dean Castro, and the entire executive team. On behalf of my boss, Administrator Michael Whitaker, and all of the FAA team that is here with us today, we're happy to allow to be a part of the program today. So I want to start by saying how much I appreciate the opportunity to be here today, and this honor to be with the Purdue community and the overall community. Here to experience all of the fine aviation that we see today. This is how my five memories of being in the many years ago when I worked in the United Airport Authority. And so I know from my experience that aviation has always been an integral part of Lafayette and the Purdue community. I've had this day circled on my calendar for quite some time, one being able to come back to Purdue, and I'm excited to speak about this opportunity. And even more excited about the opportunity to recruit today. One of the things that's important to us in my world right now is our people and the foundation that we need to build our aviation community. We are strong with more innovative and more successful and immersive talent and experience. The FAA is working with everyone to see aviation and more.
Actually,
Yeah, let's go somewhere else to eat. I mean, I don't see any place to sit, and it's going to be pretty busy. Let's see where the exit is. This is the entrance. The exit's on the other side of the Nisswanger building.
The next bit's like. Which is a representation of the strong partnership that we have with airports and with the airport here to build out infrastructure and planning for the future. I feel privileged to present at the creation of something that fuels progress and community betterment. We are indeed changing lives and making a difference in communities across the country. Speaking of making a difference, at an
otherwise. Thank you.
Of course. Thank you for coming out.
It's like we just missed the shuttle, but that's fine.